Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on solar energy trainer. In this trainer we will study about the solar cell working, we'll also see the series and parallel connections of solar cells. Also we will apply some solar maximum power point calculating formulas and we will use some home appliances or some applications which are working on solar energy. So in today's scenario, as we know that there are limited resources available for generating the energy with the fossil fuels like natural gas, coals and etc. Also there is limited resources for the nuclear energy generation also, like uranium are limited in the world and some other radioactive elements that are working with the energy generation. Scientists are right now working for the renewable energy sources. The most commonly used renewable energy sources are solar and the tidal energy. In this video, we will be see about the solar energy, how the solar energy is converted to the electrical energy and how we can use this to working on our home appliances. The photovoltaic cell is the most commonly used equipment for converting the solar energy to the electrical energy. The basic principle of photovoltaic cell is that it works on the semiconductor devices. The direct sunlight applied on the semiconductor devices that converts the energy into the current and then we can generate the voltage also. So that's how solar energy photovoltaic cells are used. We will also see this in this video with working on this practical. Now without wasting any time, let us move on to all the components or all the features of this kit. I will explain you all the features one by one and later on we will perform some basic experiments on this kit to study the solar working solar energy trainer. So this is the complete setup of solar energy trainer. This is the main energy trainer, the main board at which we have to complete and compile all the operations. This is the solar panel which consumes energy from the solar sunlight. It has a movable part so that you can easily tilt it to any of the directly 90 degree angle with this perpendicularly with the sunlight. User manual and patch codes are provided. The cable to connecting both the main unit and the solar panel with each other are also provided in the accessories. Now we'll explain you all the features and all the components of the main panel. Let us also have a closer look of this. So this is the main panel of solar energy trainer. The order code is 55502. You can use this order code to find out all the specification and features about this, what you can learn from this trainer by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Now I will explain you all the parts. The solar panel that will be explained later has the 6 solar cells. There are 6 connections. Terminal are also provided for the solar panel, positive and negative. You can connect them easily. The output will be provided when we connect the solar panel with the main trainer. You will get the output on these terminals of all the solar cells separately. Then we have the ammeter. This ammeter reads the milliampere current from 0 to 500 milliampere DC. Then we have voltmeter for measuring the voltage of solar cells, like we have 0 to 10 volt of the DC measurement for voltmeter. Then we have 5k potentiometer for changing the current and other values for potentiometric values for different type of sections. Then we have charging section. In the charging section we are using the 4 volt DC nickel cadmium battery, which is a rechargeable battery, so we will provide the solar supply to recharging the battery also. The circuits are also inbuilt and designed. Amplifier section with LEDs are provided so that you can easily study the load with different type of LED also. Some appliances and applications which will be work on the solar energy are also provided, like we have a lamp which have 2.2 volt 250 milliampere DC ratings. Then we have a fan which has 1.5 volts 400 milliampere DC rating, and a FM receiver which can be work on 6 volt DC, so we can provide output from the solar cells completely. All the solar cells will combinedly act as a complete 6 volts or more than 6 volts voltage source. Now talking about the solar panel, the second part of this unit is
having the maximum voltage of each solar cell is about 2 volts and maximum current of each solar cell is about 150 milliamperes in DC. This is the connector which can be used for connecting the cable from the main unit, and it has a complete stand so that you can easily move this solar panel to aligning it perpendicularly with the sunlight. All the solar cell will be working on the highest efficiency when it is placed inside the sunlight. Perpendicularly, sunlight will be incident on the solar cells. Now, for performing the practicals, we have put the kit in an open space where direct sunlight is arriving on the solar panel. So you can see that the solar panel is receiving the direct sunlight. So we have put it in nearby the window. So direct lighting is incidenting on the all solar panels, which is connected to our main unit right now. And here we are ready to do all the experiments performing it. Now we'll do the first experiment for voltage and current calculations of the solar cells. Now for the experiment one, we will study the voltage and current of the solar cells. The procedure is given in the user manual. We will follow all the procedure for doing it. Then we'll take the solar energy now with the solar panel, place the solar panel in the stand and adjust the panel at angle of 45 degree with the ground. Direct sunlight straight at the solar panel will be all 90 degree. So that is, we have met the setup. If the sunlight is not properly available, then any source of light like lamp can be also used directly on the solar panels. Now filled with the DB15 connector, we have connected solar energy trainer with the solar panel, and now we will wait for 1 minute to avoid errors due to the temperature fluctuations. So we have wait around 1 to 2 minutes for this, and we have already done the wait for this. Now we are ready to do the experiment. We will measure the voltage V1 of solar panel 1 S1, then cell by connecting its output across the voltmeter with the help of patch cords. Similarly, we can measure the voltages on V1, V2, V3 and V4 and V6. All the 6 solar panels voltages we can measure. Then we measure the current of all the solar panels connecting them to the ampere meter, and we'll note down all the readings in the observation table given in the user manual. Now for measurement of the voltage and current, we'll use patch cords. Patch cords will be connected on positive and negative terminal of S1, and herely positive will be connected with the positive of voltmeter and negative will be connected with the negative of voltmeter. Here as we connected both, here you can see the voltage readings in the voltmeter is around 2 volts right now. So we have all the solar cells 2 volts each, and current will mention the current also. For measuring the current, we just connect positive and negative to the ampere meter as well. Here the current is about 100 milliamperes for this solar cell 1. Now similarly, we'll measure the voltage of the solar cell 2 as well. So solar cell 2 is also getting around 2 volts. Similarly, solar cell 3 is getting also 2 volts. At the same time, we'll mention the current of all the cells as well, one by one taking them. It's also around 2 volts. This is also around 2 volts, and the last one is also around 2 volts. So all the solar cells are giving voltages around 2 volts. Now we'll check the current of all of them also. So in the solar cell 2, we are getting the current about 50 milliampere. That is because that the proper intensity of the light on the solar cell 1 is greater than the solar cell 2. So that's why current is having some difference. Similarly, we'll measure the current already in the S3. Current is slightly dropped. In S4, we have again increased the current around 80 milliamperes, and this is also around 80 milliamperes in S5, and in S6 we are having around 30 to 40 milliamperes of current. It depends on the intensity of light, how strong the intensity of the light right now going on and incidenting on the solar panel. So if I till the solar panel, just slightly adjust it, we can get the fluctuation also on the light as well. So here amount slightly increased due to the adjustment. Here you can see right now cloudy atmosphere is continuously going on over here, so that's why current and voltage will also decrease, because all things are dependent on the solar light properly. Now after taking all the voltages and current, we can mention them in the observation table given in the user manual, and here we can measure and check the study of voltage and current of solar cells. Now moving to the next experiment, which is the study of voltage and current of the solar panel or solar cells in series and parallel combination. So for this, we will connect all the solar cells S1, S2, S3 up to X6 in the series. We will connect positive of S1 and negative of S1 with the positive of S2, negative of S2 with the positive of S3. In a similar manner, we can combine all the 6 solar cells and check the series output of all the solar cells. And similarly, we'll do the parallel combination. In the parallel combination, we'll connect positive of S1 with the positive of S2 with the positive of S3. Similarly, all the solar cells, positive and negative, will be combined with each other, and then we get the voltage on the voltmeter, and also we'll measure the current. Both things will be mentioned in the observation table, and then we can calculate the theoretical readings as well and get the output also. So firstly, we will do the series connection of all the solar cells. So S1, positive of S1, will be directly connected to the positive of voltmeter, and now we will connect all the solar cells in series. For this, negative of S1 will be connected with the positive of S2. Similarly, negative of S2 will be connected positive of S3. Negative of S3 of will be connected with S4 positive. Negative of S4 will be connected with positive of S5. And at the last, we will connect negative of S6 with positive of S6. Sorry, negative of S5 with positive of S6. And here we will connect the solar cell negative to the voltmeter, and at this time the voltage is more than 10 volts, so we'll decrease it because we have voltmeter of only 10 volts per reading. Now if all the solar cells are getting the readings about 2 volts, so this is our final reading at the voltmeter, which is around 9.6 or 9.5 volts. And as the intensity of the light or the sunlight will increase, we can get, you can see the voltage is right now 10 volts, because all the solar cells have about 2 volts of the reading, and as the intensity of light increase, we are getting the voltage in parallel, in series, is the equal of all the voltages, which is around 10 volts for all the 5 solar cells. Now we'll measure the current also. For this, here as we have connected the series combination of all 5 solar cells in the milliampere meter, and we are getting the current is around 40 or 30 milliamperes, because in the series connection the current is decreased. When we do the parallel connection, current will be slightly increased. In the parallel connection, the ampere meter has around 500 milliamperes of the rating, so we'll connect first 3 solar cells and check the parallel current of all the solar cells. Now we will do the parallel combination of all the solar cells. So firstly, we will connect the positive to the positive of voltmeter, and continuously we'll watch the voltage. That's how voltage is changing. Here the voltage of single solar cell is right now 2 volts, so we'll connect another solar cell in parallel with this. For connecting them in parallel, we just connect positive of S1 with the positive of S2 and negative of S1 with the negative of S2. In the similar manner, we will connect all of them in the parallel combination. So S2 positive will be connected with S3. Negative of S2 will be connected with negative of S3. Similarly, S3 positive will be connected with S4 positive. S4 positive with the negative with the negative of S4. Similarly, S5. So in the parallel combination, the voltage will not drop across the voltmeter because voltage in parallel remains same, but the current will be increased. Now for the last one, so we have connected all the six solar cells in the parallel and voltage is constant, which is 2 volt. So now we'll try to measure the current. For sure the current meter will burn out if we connected the all solar cells in 6 of them in the parallel combination with the board multimeter. So we'll try with first a digital multimeter and then we'll connect up to 3 solar cells to the ampere meter for measuring the current as well. So now we have set up the digital multimeter for measuring the current of all the solar cells in series and parallel. For this we'll connect positive of multimeter probe in series with the negative of the voltmeter, and here you can see the current in the multimeter is around 174 milliamperes measured by all the voltages. Now we'll connect, we'll remove the three of solar cells with the parallel combination and then we measure the output current on the onboard milliampere meter. Let us see what will be the output. For this we'll remove the three solar cells. So here we have now connected up to 3 solar cells in parallel. Voltage is 2 volts for all the 3. Now we'll connect it to the milliampere meter and check what is the current of this. So this is showing around 50 milliamperes of current because there is cloud on the sun right now. If the cloud is removed, the current will be increased. So this is only about 50 milliampere. So we can connect some more solar cells to it. Carefully connect solar cells to measure the current up to 500 milliamperes because the meter has a capacity of only 500 milliamperes. Here you can see as I connected one more solar cell, the current slightly increased. Now we'll connect some more. So here we'll connect one more solar cell. It depends on the intensity of light, how much current you are getting from the sunlight. Here you can see the current is now slightly increasing up to 150-200 milliamps, and over here the sunlight is also increasing and decreasing, and that's why we are receiving the current fluctuations also. So that is how the solar cell current fluctuates. Up and downs will be arise when the intensity of the solar is changes. So this will be also beneficial to understanding the current variation of solar cells with the intensity of light as well. Now after taking all the readings, you can also sum of all the voltages, taking it separately and calculate and compare it with the parallel connection voltage that we are getting. In similar case, you can do it also in the current one as well. All the currents taken by separately of all the solar cells that we have taken in the first practical as well, and then you can parallel combination in the current is also mentioned in the observation table. We compare it with the calculated and combined connections current as well. Now moving to the next practical, experiment number 3, we will study both the current voltage characteristics and the power curve to find out the maximum power point and efficiency of the solar cell. First two points will be remain same. If the sunlight is properly, you can connect a lamp over the solar lamp also, or the solar cell panel, and we'll connect solar cell with the main unit. After that, we need to form this circuit using the solar panel. Positive of solar panel will be going to positive voltmeter, negative of this will be going to positive of ampere meter, and negative of ampere meter will again go to negative of solar cell. We'll connect a variable resistance potentiometer that we have already discussed, and follow the procedure to find out all the specification and details in this practical. So here we have connected 3 of the solar cell in the parallel combination. So as per the circuit, we will connect positive to the voltmeter, connect positive terminal of solar cell to the P1, sorry. So first we will connect it to the P1 of the potentiometer, then P2 to positive terminal of ampere meter. So we'll connect P2 to positive terminal of ampere meter. Negative terminal of ampere meter will be connected with the negative of the solar cell. So this is our negative that we have already connected. Now we'll connect it to the negative of ampere meter. Here our current is showing right now is about 150 milliamperes, or more than that, 160 we can say it. Now connect positive terminal to P1 of voltmeter. So we'll connect positive of P1 to positive of voltmeter. And negative to the P2. And here the voltage are fluctuated slightly, which is around 30 to 40 millivolts, or we can say it is around 0.3 or 0.4 volts. Now for calculating the MPP, the maximum power point, we have to record all the corresponding voltage and current value into observation table and gradually move the potentiometer in anticlockwise direction so that resistance of the potentiometer decreases. Now measure the resistance at every point where we want to measure the voltage and current in different values. So we'll mention the resistance at different points at similar corresponding value. We'll measure the voltage and current of all the points at where the resistance is, and then we calculate the power in watts using P equals to VI formula. Then we find out and draw the IV characteristics curve, and then we do the power versus voltage curve also. For this, right now you can see I have ready the multimeter for this purpose as well. So at the first instant, here we can say voltage is 0 and current is about 150 milliamps. Slightly will increase both of them at some point. So here voltage is around 0.5 volts. And at this point, we will measure the resistance. So resistance is 7 ohm. In the multimeter, we can indicate it clearly. Now we again connect P1 and P2 at this respective positions. And here again, voltage and current will remain same. So we have 0.5 volts and current is around 125 milliamperes. So we'll mention it in the observation table. Similarly, we'll increase some voltage. So here we have now reached up to 1 volt and current is 100 milliamperes. So at this time, we'll also mention and take the resistance value. So this time resistance is 12 ohms. So we have increased resistance slightly. Now we'll increase some more. Here the voltage is now 1.5 and current is around 50 milliamps, and we'll increase it completely. So at this point the voltage is 2 volts and current is around 40 milliamperes. So we'll note down all the readings in the observation table. If you want to take more readings, you can add some more solar cells and get your detail and a lot of readings characteristics. So more of the readings, more of the accurate graph will you find. Now after taking down all the readings, you can calculate the power, as we have voltage and current at all the points. And with the voltage readings, you can find out the maximum power point, which is the maximum point at where the voltage and current characteristic graph will be at the maximum point. So that's how you can calculate the maximum power point of this solar cell system. And the maximum power point is the maximum value of power in the above curve. The resistance RMPP, resistance at the maximum power point at which the output power is maximum, can be calculated using the formula RMPP equals to VMPP upon IMPP. So you can calculate the maximum resistance as well. So in the second part of the last practical, we can calculate the efficiency of the solar cell. For this, efficiency of solar cell formula is given as neta equals to P output upon P input, where P out is the electrical maximum power point that we have get and calculated on this. And for efficiency, we can put the P in value. All the formulas and explanations and detailed derivation is given in the user manual. You can study it and find out your maximum efficiency through this complete study. And the efficiency of solar cells will be lies between 12 to 15% when you calculate it, put by putting all the values after calculation and practical. Now for the next experiment, experiment number 5, we'll study the application of solar cells for charging the nickel cadmium battery so that the loads can be used even while the module is in unexposed to the solar direct sunlight. So we'll follow the procedure. We'll connect the rechargeable battery, nickel cadmium battery, which is already connected and fitted inside the main unit, in the holder provided on the charging section, the charging section that we have already explained. Battery needs voltage around 1 to 1.5 to 2 volts for standard charging at 80 milliamperes about 15 hours. Some batteries are provided with facilities for quick charging at 210 milliamperes about 3 to 4 hours. So connect the solar cells in the series and parallel combination as per the required rating. So we have connected 3 solar cells in the parallel right now. Now with the help of patch cord, we'll connect positive terminal of the solar cell to the positive terminal of diode and negative terminal of the solar cell to the negative terminal of battery section. Now we'll connect the terminal T1 to the positive terminal of battery. Then we connect the voltmeter across the battery terminal with the patch cord. We can observe the voltage variation in the voltmeter. So we'll first connect the positive terminal of solar cells to the positive terminal of diode on the charging section. Now we'll using patch cord, T1 of the diode section will be connected to positive terminal of battery, and negative terminal of the solar cell will be connected with the negative terminal of battery section. Now we'll connect voltmeter across the battery terminals so that we can observe the fluctuations of the voltage. So this is the positive of the battery and this is the negative of this battery. We'll connect it to the voltmeter and here the voltage variation will be observed because now battery starts charging using power from the solar cells and right now battery is at around 3.6 or 3.8 volts and we can charge it up to 4 volts because it has a 4 volt battery inside it. So 4 volts will be the maximum output for this. So that's how battery charging is going on from this solar panel. Now for adding the load in this segment, we'll connect positive terminal of this battery to the T2, which is the amplifier section. Now T3, which is the amplifier sections to the load, positive of the load, which is the LED provided over here, and negative of this load will be connected to the negative of battery. Here you can see the load are now slightly lightened up and the voltage is slightly dropped because we have connected the load in series. So here we can observe that the group of LED glows where load is operating with the solar energy and battery is charging with the solar energy. Now if we want to increase the charging time to decrease and load to be increased some more, we can add some more solar panels with the parallel condition. And now if we want to direct operation of load with the charged battery, that is when the module is unexposed to light, we'll remove the connection from the solar cells from the charging section and the charged nickel cadmium battery provides electricity to the load even the panel is unexposed to the light and battery will discharge, then you can reconnect previous connections for charging the battery. Right now battery is not having the proper charges right time to increase the output voltage, so for this we need to put this solar modules in the solar light exposure for about 3 to 4 hours and after that battery will get the proper charge and get some proper output current. So that's why load will be continuously exposed. We can remove the solar cells positive and negative right now charging section, but battery will not work as per the charging outputs. Now moving to the next experiment in which we will study the application of solar cells providing electrical energy to domestic appliances such as lamp, fan and radio. For this we will measure the voltage and current of the solar cell, connect them in series or parallel combination as we require, and for operating the lamp first we will need to measure the voltage around 2.2 volts and current is around 250 milliamperes. If the voltage and current will do not match the same rating, the appliances will not be working. So we'll match the rating and then we connect positive negative terminal to the solar cells lamp combination and to the lamp, and when we observe the lamp is glowing. In similar manner we will observe the same rating, we'll make the rating 1.5 volts 400 milliamperes for producing and operating the fan, and similarly we'll operate the FM radio also. For that we need to maintain the voltage around 5 to 6 volts. Current will be dependent on the output required frequency on the FM radio stations. So now firstly we will going to check the ratings for operating the lamp. So here 3 solar modules is right now connected in parallel and then we connect the positive and negative to the solar modules. Voltage is 2 volts and current is around 150 milliamperes. So we'll add one more solar cell and let us see what is the output current, and this should be around 250 so that we can operate the lamp. So using patch codes we'll add one more solar cell in parallel and similarly corresponding current will be also increased. Now we again check the voltage and currents. The voltage around right now approximately perfect 2 volts and current is around 200 milliampere. So it is more than 200 milliampere. So at this time we can check whether our load lamp is working or not. So we'll connect it to the positive and negative across the lamp. Here the lamp is slightly giving some current and slightly some glowing is produced. So we'll increase one more solar cell over here because it's depend on the intensity of the sunlight, what are the output exposure of the solar panel. And here we will measure the current and voltage once again. So voltages are 2 volts, which is enough. And here current is around 300 milliamperes, it is 290 milliamperes. So this should be sufficient to operate the bulb load. So we'll connect it to the bulb. Here you can see the bulb is glowing. If there are a lot of exposed lightings over here, that's why you cannot be seen it properly. Very slight current is passing through the load and the lamp is glowing slightly. Maybe it not be seenable to the camera, but with my naked eyes I can see the bulb is glowing. Now in similar manner we will also operate the motor or the fan over here. So we'll connect positive and negative to the fan's terminal and here our fan starts rotating. The polarity and the direction of the fan depends on the polarity that we have connected to positive and negative across the fan. Now similarly the voltage and currents are sufficient to operate the FM receiver as well. If does not go, we can increase it further. So we'll increase the volume controller. Antenna is also provided so we can match the different frequencies. Here you can see FM receiver is working with the solar cell power. So that's how we can operate different types of appliances with the solar cell energies.
So here our demonstration of the solar energy trainer is now completed. You can do your practicals as I described in this video, or you can follow the user manual, all the instruction. Theoretical details about the solar energy trainers are also given in the user manual. You can study it for getting the detailed knowledge about this trainer. And if you like this video, if you find the content of this video useful for you, you can like the video. Also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the solar energy trainer, how the solar energy nowadays is working, how they can perform different type of experiments, how they can get the different type of knowledge that we have performed in this video also. Also you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with different type of practical information with the different type of trainers are uploaded, so you can get on there and go through the videos, different type of videos, and get clear or different interesting topics of the education related. And also don't forget to press the bell button over here so that whenever we upload our new video with the new trainer, with the new technology, you can also get the notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video and we'll meet in the next video very soon.